brand new 1985 cars in their dealer showrooms all across the country just a few weeks from now, but our consumer reporter Tom Bakar got a sneak preview today of the brand new General Motors plastic car, and here's Tommy to tell us all about it.
Well, what's really interesting, all the car enthusiast magazines are just wild about this car. These are exciting times in the car industry. In fact, Detroit is again flexing its muscles, and the magazines are saying Pontiac's new Fiero is a smash hit, and we hope they're right, but the magazines have been wrong before.
It was originally conceived as a commuter car in the late 70s, but by the time it actually hit the road, it was a full-blown, high-tech, high-mileage sports car made with none other than a plastic body. The Pontiac Fiero is sure to be a hit with those folks who've always wanted a sports car that any American dealer could fix. And at between $10,000 and $11,000, for virtually a fully equipped, air-conditioned, six-speaker stereo, power-everything, two-seat package, Pontiac feels, and with some justification, that it could sell well over 100,000 Fieros in 1984. Even with its mid-rear mounted engine, there is some decent lockable storage space. The mid-rear mounted engine gives the car excellent handling and stability. Though the body is plastic, the car still weighs 2,500 pounds. That's heavier than a BMW 318i, about the same weight as the new Ford Tempo, and just 300 pounds lighter than a Chrysler New Yorker. The road test by Car and Driver, Road and Track, and Motor Trend rate its average fuel economy at 23 to 30 honest miles per gallon. DiGiulio Pontiac salesman Eddie Conrad has sold high-priced imported sports cars in his life, and he says this car seems to be a winner.
That's approximately a 15-year experience with automobiles, not to mention also American cars. And to me, this kind of technology and the fact that General Motors has gone into the research work of this car for over 10 years, finally coming up with the final cut-down model 5 years ago, I think it's going to be an exceptional automobile.
But as advanced as the car is, it still represents new technology for General Motors, just like the X-Body cars did a few years ago. And after a series of disastrous recalls, that car has been discontinued. Should it happen to this car, the real credibility of new GM technology would weigh in the balance.
Professional road tests notwithstanding, this car has a lot to prove and not much time to do it in.
Right now, the only model is in Fremont, but plenty have been built to accommodate what is expected to be a large demand, and albeit all Pontiac dealers within just a couple of weeks.
Those magazines are excited, but I don't hear a lot of enthusiasm out of you about the car.
These magazines are real excited about the X-Body cars and a number of other cars that have been discontinued. As Detroit tries to pull its way out of its problems, it is certainly doing a lot of exciting things. I think the real question here is this car really the answer? My guess is...